In order to be able to use a Smith chart, in step one, we first have to normalize the load impedance. Drawing it backwards there. All right, so little ZL is capital ZL over Z naught. And ZL is given as 80 plus J, 75. Z naught is given as 50. So we get 1.6 plus J, 1.5. So we have little ZL is R plus JX. So in step two, we're going to plot this on the Smith chart, and we need to find the intersection of the R equal 1.6 circle with the X equals positive 1.5 arc. So for step two, that's shown on this slide. This is the R equal 1.6 circle. And the top half of the Smith chart has positive admittances, so this is the positive 1.5 arc for X. So that's R X equal. All right, then we need to find how far around the Smith chart we need to rotate. So we need to know the distance in wavelength. And we're given details about the dielectric. So we can first find the speed at which the wave is traveling, 1 over square root of mu epsilon, which is 1 over mu naught, because this is a non-magnetic material, we can assume, unless we're told otherwise, epsilon naught, epsilon r. So these are both constants, and we are given a value for epsilon r, so we can plug all that in. And we get 2.07 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. Then we have another relationship for UP, is lambda F. And that's where we see our lambda appear. So since we know UP, and we are given F, the frequency is 100 megahertz, then we can plug that in. We can solve for lambda. We have lambda is UP over F, which turns out to be 2.1 meters. So the given distance of 1.38 meters can now be converted to wavelengths. So we would take, that would be 1.38 meters, and we have 2.1 meters per wavelength. Always make sure the units work out, so you'd have meters would cancel, you'd end up with wavelengths, and this turns out to be 2/3 of a wavelength. So that is more than half a wavelength. If you notice on the Smith chart, if you go all the way around the Smith chart, that is half of a wavelength. So that means we can rotate all the way around the Smith chart, but all we're really going to see at the end is the distance that we've rotated, which is 2 lambda over 3 minus lambda over 2. So that's the amount we actually need to rotate to get our final answer. And we're going to also rotate towards the generator. So remember, we have this scale, rotate towards the generator. We're at the load, we're moving towards the generator. So we want to rotate our plotted load impedance, and we want to rotate this towards the generator a distance of 2 lambda over 3 total, so all the way around the Smith chart. And then the remainder brings us to, okay, so first you can read off where we're at, so draw a straight line out. And you just have to make sure you're consistent with scale you're using on the outside. So let's go ahead and use the wavelengths towards the generator. We can read off the value here, would be 0.198. So if we add on half and then the remainder, we should wind up at 0.365. So then we also can, if you don't have something that can draw a circle, a nice circle for you, what you can do is you can draw a straight line and measure this distance using a ruler. And then once you know how far to rotate, you can draw another straight line and just measure that same distance out, and that will tell you where your Zn should be. So our final step is to read Zn directly from the Smith chart so we can see which circle is it goes through. And you might have to interpolate a little bit between circles to get a better estimate. And also which arc. And since it's in the bottom half of the Smith chart, we're going to get a negative value. So if you look at the circles it goes through about 0.65 circle. So that is this circle. I can't draw it very well. But the same kind of circle we had on the previous when we were plotting ZL. And then the arc, let's see, something like that. So if you read off that value, it'd be about 0.9. So this is little Zn. So don't forget, we have to still denormalize. And so we would take little Zn, multiply this time to denormalize by Z naught, and that will give us the true physical Zn, capital Zn value. So we would take 0.65 minus J.9, multiply times 50, and our final answer is 32.5 minus J.45 ohms.